Hey everyone, so without doing much ado, we are starting with part one of our series, that is order service which will be sending order to order queue and listening to reply from customer queue. So let's jump to our launchpad, that is start.spring.io. The name of the project we are giving as Spring RabbitMQ order service. And the dependencies, this is a Gradle project in Java, and we are doing in Java 8. And the dependencies which we are going to add here are web. First dependency is web, then second is Lombok. Third dependency is going to be RabbitMQ. And the fourth one is MongoDB, as we already discussed the tech stack. So here we are adding Spring Web, then Lombok, then RabbitMQ, and then MongoDB. Mongo and RabbitMQ. So with this, the spring.io is going to generate the zip file for us and would be downloaded in our download folder. So we will unzip that, and we will import that project into our IntelliJ workspace, and open that in a new window, and we'll start with that. So yeah, here we are just unzipping it and placing it to the proper place. So before starting the project, we should have the RabbitMQ already installed in our system. In my system, I have already installed RabbitMQ, and it is server is running. The commands for running the RabbitMQ in Mac, in my system I'm using brew. So the command is brew services start, and for stopping it, stop, and then followed by RabbitMQ. So that's the command. So once the RabbitMQ is started successfully, we can test via login through guest, and password is guest, and the URL is localhost port number 15672, and here it should show the queue tab should show the queues which are currently running on our server, RabbitMQ server. So let's start it with, let's go to the new project from existing source, and here we are importing our project, so our Gradle project. So we are selecting Gradle and going further. So now we are going to create the package structure. So here we will be having five kind of packages. One is config, next is controller, the third one is repository, fourth is DTO, and the final one is services. So as their name suggests, we in config we will be having configuration classes. Here in this particular service we will be having messaging config for RabbitMQ related beans, and then we will be having controller, which will be a REST controller, a service which will service package will be having two interface and implementation for order service, and in the application properties we would be setting the MongoDB related configurations like MongoDB spring.data.mongodb.database name. So here we are giving database name as OrderDB, and the port on which it would be running is 27017. So with this configuration, let's start with our first class, that is the configuration file. As I mentioned earlier, I'm giving the name as messaging configuration, and this messaging configuration we need to annotate as add configuration for the string spring to take consideration of or load this into the spring context. So yeah, so and the beans which we are going to create here are the queue. First we need to create one queue, and then we need to create topic exchange, then we need to create the binders for the queues, and then we need to create the RabbitMQ template connector. So all those means we are going to create here. For references, we can refer the RabbitMQ link which will be provided in the description section. So here we are going to have two queues, one is order queue and the other one is customer queue. So for that we need to configure two configurations, basically two queues and two binders for this. And both the binders would be binding those queues to one topic or one exchange. So yeah, that's pretty much of it. So we are having consumer queue and the other one is order. So now we will be having a topic since this whole scenario or use case is surrounding order in order context. So we are considering the name for the topic as order topic or order exchange. So we are giving the name of this topic exchange as order underscore topic, and then we need to annotate all of these. We need to annotate as @bin so that these can be auto wired and taken care in the Spring context or by the Spring container. So next is we need to configure the binders. So as I said, two queues we are going to use. So we need to have order binding, and then we need to have the other binding for customer queue. Both these bindings will be binding queues to the topic exchange. So here we can see the syntax. We are using bind, and in with bind we are passing the queue name and the to exchange. In exchange we are passing the exchange bean which we have just now created, and then with order in the with we are passing basically the key, and the key we are simply passing as the order queue dot get name. So whatever the name of our queue is, it will be same as the key name also will be the same. Then after all this configuration, we need to define the converter, which is basically so this particular configuration we are doing for the second queue, that is consumer queue, the similar configuration. And then now we need to do the converter. We need to add the message converter bean here. And one caveat here, always make sure we are going to use the core AMQP, Spring core AMQP library here. So we should, all our beans or all our library classes, whatever we are using, they must be from that AMQP, Spring AMQP core. So yeah, so message converter we are going to use JSON to JSON message converter here. So we are adding that here, and then AMQP template is nothing but here we will be defining the RabbitMQ template, and that is the super class for this. AMQP template is a super class for RabbitMQ template. So we are going to configure it here. And then that bean will be injected in our Spring context. So yeah, we are setting the converter here. In the previous steps, whatever converter we are adding in the container, we are setting that container, that converter here in this step. And finally, we will be annotating it as a bean. So that's the configuration we need to do for RabbitMQ. For the any service, we should start by thinking about the DTO or the model object, like what are going to be the classes, what are going to be the fields. And then in our case, in order status, we will be in our case, we are having an enumerator. Enumeration, that is order status with three states we can have. One is pending, decline, or accept. We are considering only three steps, and then we are defining the order class here. And @document, by saying @document, we are actually creating, this will create a collection
in MongoDB.
And we are going to have the fields, all the fields which are needed here. So if you remember in the first part, we have seen the table structure for the. So the ID is an identifier in the collection, the record identifier, we can say that would be the order ID. We are going to create an order service interface which will be having all the methods. So basically for this service we will be having methods like create order update from queue. So that is the listener which we are going to configure. And yeah, here we are creating another class which will be implementing our interface. So we are going to have a repository class, repository interface, which will be, and that we will be auto wiring in our service. Repository will be having, we need to pass the model that is order, and the ID is going to be a string. So yeah, and then that repository interface we need to bind, or we need to auto wire that in our service. And then this rabbit listener we need to add to the, so this listener will be, this order update message from queue will be listening from the consumer queue, from the consumer queue of the RabbitMQ. This queue will be this will be listening the incoming reply from the consumer service or the customer service. Reply will be listen here, and the create order will be actually saving the order part in create while order creation, and update will also be updating the order. Now we are going to create order controller. So in order controller also we need to focus on the we need to see how we are going to place our order into the order MQ, order queue. So that the place order method will be actually doing that for us. So we are calling the create order here, and then that create order will actually be placing the order into the order queue. So here we are adding that, then RabbitMQ template we need to auto wire here, and then RabbitMQ template dot convert and send. In convert and send we need to pass key and the object. So order object we are going to pass, and the key is nothing but our queue name, so we are placing in on order queue. So this is what we need to focus here. Other is simply this order status endpoint will simply checking the status, but this again caveat here is this is not the real-time status. So on the postman, once we hit that, we will be able to see the status, but that status can be stale also, because once the reply is received placed on the queue, our server will straight away pick it up from there then and there itself. So now we are bouncing our server, and once that is started, we can create the collection for our final testing. For now we cannot test it because the customer service also we need to have, and the customer would be expecting the customer ID. This particular when we place the order we need to have the customer ID also, so until that time we cannot test it. So yeah, this is the collection, this is the postman collection we are going to use for our final testing. So with this, here ends our part one. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please like our work and share our work and subscribe to our work. Yes, thanks for watching and have a nice day.